Hello and welcome to another instalment of Trusted Reviews Tech of the Week. I'm Thomas Newton, Computing Editor, and I have with me here my colleague, Computing Writer Ryan Jones. And this week we're talking about this absolute monstrosity here.
Yes.
We're talking about the Acer Predator Triton 900. As you can see, or maybe you can't see, let me just turn it around for you there. This is a really interesting looking high-end gaming laptop.
A unique high-end gaming laptop.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't really seen anything quite like this before. It's a little bit like a sort of Microsoft Surface Pro, but like hulked out. It's gone to the gym and it's like wearing a big fancy black leather jacket now.
And it's got some gaming hardware inside.
It does indeed have some gaming hardware inside. Specifically, it has a Max-Q NVIDIA 2080.
Mm-hmm. The best one you can get in a laptop?
Pretty much the best gaming GPU you can fit inside a laptop right now. If we just move the display back like that and we...
It's a tall flip behind as well.
This is obviously like a fancy glass plate where you can see some of the cooling pipes and one of the fans doing its thing. But a little bit like if you remember the Predator Helios 700 laptop we had in a few weeks back. This also has an interesting cooling system where cold air is drawn in from the outside. That's forced around the heat pipes as usual, and then the warm air is blasted out of the back and side. So all of the those components that are going to get really quite hot and sticky under the collar, they can be quite nicely cooled. So you can push the performance of this machine with some built-in overclocking software.
There's like presets for overclock, right? So you just click a profile, yes. It'll automatically overclock it. So if you're not into your overclocking, it's still not that daunting.
Right. So if you've not really overclocked anything before, this is a really easy way to sort of get used to that kind of a world of like, you know, just tweaking performance of your system. And I've seen some very good benchmarking results of this so far.
Okay.
Pretty much on par with what I saw with the Helios 700.
And they were pretty meaty scores, right?
So. Yes, yeah. I was getting over 100 frames a second on a Tomb Raider. In Ultra, that was on Full HD.
Full HD, okay.
And on 4K, I was getting close to like the 40-50 mark, which is kind of like, again, that for a game of that sort of, that's that graphically demanding, is pretty good, I think.
Well, that's my point on that. Like, how often do we get a 4K gaming laptop in? What can do a performance good enough to play a AAA game? Like, it's kind of unheard of.
Not very often.
No, we're only about getting to a stage of desktop gaming where you can play 4K about 60 frames a second. So for a laptop to be even close to that is really impressive.
Yeah, so I'm glad that you brought up the display. To my mind, it's easily like the biggest talking point about the Triton 900.
Okay.
As you said, it's really uncommon to see a 4K display on a gaming laptop. Mm-hmm. And it is by far one of the best displays I've tested on any device this year. So the sRGB and Adobe RGB coverage is pretty much perfect. It's almost 100% on both of those color spaces, which is really unheard of. A lot of gaming laptops, the color space coverage tends to be not that fantastic.
Yeah, that's where we usually cut corners, right? Because if you can connect it up to an external monitor, then if you're going to make any sacrifices, you're going to make the screen not as like punchy and accurate.
And you do not get that here at all. The color accuracy is simply fantastic, and the viewing angles are also really, really strong. It's got a really nice reflective coating. It looks really good.
Yeah.
I think the only thing, if I had to sort of nitpick about this, is the fact that this display only refreshes up to 60 hertz.
That's an issue.
It can be an issue if you're playing something with the graphics settings dialed down because you want to push performance. If you're in a competitive environment, and I've benched some older games, and I've also benched AAA titles with the graphics settings dialed down, and this thing can easily do over 100 frames per second in Full HD and in 4K. In some circumstances.
Yeah, but if you're one of those competitive people, especially playing a shooter, you're going to want like the refresh rate to be like approaching 120, 144. Yeah. So to have a 60 hertz is like not a deal breaker, but if you're a competitive gamer, it's probably you might be tempted to either get an external monitor or get a different laptop.
Right. So a couple of things. There's a Thunderbolt port here on the side, and round here, actually, that's a lie. It's around here on the back. You've got a DisplayPort and HDMI connection. So you can output to a monitor that refreshes at a higher rate than this if you like, but that's an extra expense, isn't it?
It is an extra expense.
On the subject of expense, I should point out that this particular model, which comes with an RTX 2080, 32 gig of RAM and an i9 9980HK processor, it's just shy of £4,000. That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money.
So, yeah, $4,000.
So do you can get like gaming laptops for these days, just like a little bit under £1,000. Obviously, it's no way near the specs of this,
right.
But
yeah.
You can play some games. So this is a lot of money.
Like, yeah, this really is at like the absolute high end of laptop gaming at the moment. You're not just getting a fancy design here, of course, although it does look very, very nice. It's a high quality 4K display, and you've pretty much got some of the best laptop components, processor, and GPU-wise that you can possibly hope to afford at the moment.
Cool.
So yeah, this is kind of like cream of the crop, and therefore, you know, you're going to be paying a lot of money for something like this.
Right, let's cut to the chase and say cream of the crop.
Okay.
If you're going to buy a gaming laptop for £4,000, is this the one to go for?
I've yet to finish testing this fully, and I'll have to let you know what I think about this in retrospect.
Because we've had recent examples recently, when we had the Alienware Area 51M,
yep,
was basically like a big, hefty game laptop, around about the same price, and it doesn't have like the tiltable screen, but that special sauce is that it can... You can upgrade a processor, use a desktop processor, you can upgrade the GPU and upgrade all those kind of stuff.
Yeah,
but with this, you get a 4K display, it's also tiltable, so I guess it depends on which one you prefer.
I think if you were also looking for something to do some heavy photo editing on, and possibly even video editing, then this might be a sort of shoe-in for that
That's good. That's true.
I can't help but point out the similarities between this and Acer's own Concept D9 Pro, which I saw at IFA 2019 a few weeks ago. Very similar, not only in terms of design, but execution as well. You've got a trackpad over on the right-hand side. The keyboard switches felt kind of similar to me. You know, you could do some video editing on this.
Yeah.
It's not, you know, obviously because it doesn't have a Quadro GPU, it doesn't have all the drivers built in, but if you wanted to play games as well as pull something together in Premiere Pro, then this might be a better option for you.
And that's worth mentioning as well, that NVIDIA have recently released these NVIDIA Studio drivers.
Right.
So obviously you've got the gaming drivers you've got, but you also got these Studio drivers now, were optimized for creative work rather than gaming. And NVIDIA lets you swap between those whenever you want, so you can just install the driver, Studio drivers, and then when you want to go back to gaming, install the gaming drivers. So you could theoretically use this as a proper certified, like, creative laptop.
In theory. I have not tested this out yet.
Yes, in theory.
I'm not a creative person, I don't edit video, so I wouldn't be best placed to sort of offer much opinion on that, but the potential is there for sure. And again, I'm going to reiterate, this display is fantastic. It's one of the best I've seen all year. It's really quite, you know, we see a lot of displays, obviously, so it's really something when you test something out and get it out of the box, and then you just turn it on and it's like, wow.
Yeah.
It just looks good straight away.
And I get people saying to me, like, is there a point of having a 4K display when it's so small? But, like, as soon as you put on Tomb Raider, I know it straight away, like, that's not HD, that's really looking really sharp.
It is noticeable, yeah.
I reckon there's definitely noticeable difference.
There's a big debate about 4K gaming. Is it worth it? It's certainly a lot of money, but I think in this case, you do really get what you pay for. The quality is immediately noticeable. I would say, if you haven't checked out 4K gaming yet, or even 4K TV yet, the difference is like night and day. It's honestly, it all sounds very theoretical to say it's got, you know, it's just got more pixels, it's more detailed, but it's more than that, I think.
So.
It is a bit of a shame that this only refreshes to 60 hertz, so like you could have a game that's giving you more than 60 frames a second, but you're not really going to be able to appreciate the difference of that unless you output it to another monitor. But more money, yeah, absolutely. But if you've already got one of those, then, you know, that's less of a problem, I guess. But so without wanting to go around the houses on those same two points again, so we should wrap up this episode of Tech of the Week. We're halfway through testing this now, and the review will be live on the site shortly. I'm really, really impressed with this, and more so the fact that it doesn't really weigh that much. It's not that heavy at all. And if you remember the Helios 700 that we had in, that was about 5 kilos, that was an absolute bruiser.
You still want to put it in your rucksack and take it to the office every day, though, would you?
Maybe not. I think I would also want a case for this just to sort of protect everything, to make sure that nothing gets scratched or damaged. But, like, I think at a pinch you probably could. This is portable, whereas some so-called gaming laptops that are basically desktop replacements are not portable, really. But if you've got any questions or comments, you know what to do. Drop them below the line. And please, if you've enjoyed this video, hit the bell and hit subscribe as well. Yeah, that's it. That's Tech of the Week. This is the Acer Predator Triton 900. I've been Tom Newton. You've been Ryan Jones.
Yeah. Thanks for watching.
See you soon.
Bye.